tepi. So let me now show you some sample custom producer. So what if you want to write your own custom producers? We'll see that now.
Shiva, this application what you showed, it's only on the shell we wrote it and consumed, but what the real application where we writing, like using the scalar or just using the shell, that concept I didn't get.
We didn't discuss that yet.
Okay.
So that is why, I mean, when if you want to write, if you want to listen on a port number, or if you want to read through files or the log messages, so you can write your own custom producer, and your consumer you can sync it with your Spark streaming. So that's what I am trying to show you now. Okay. So this is your typical Kafka producer API. So Kafka producer, where, so if you observe the producer command that we have run, yep. So in the producer command, what are the things that you have to give? The broker list, the host names and port numbers, and the topic to which you have to connect, and so once connected, we were sending the messages to it. So that is what we'll do in the API also. It's a simple one only. So Kafka, some outbound producer, some or the other way, you should keep on sending the messages to it. Okay. So for that, I'm taking this brokers and the topic, and these two are additional parameters. So you have to specify the broker's name in the Bootstrap server's config property of the producer configuration. So all I am doing is, so I'm preparing a properties hash map, a string comma object hash map. The string is a key, and the which is nothing but a product property and the values. Okay. And value serializer class, something, some default common string serializer, and key serializer class config, the same string serializer, and Kafka producer. So I'm creating a producer object with Kafka producer class, string comma string, and providing these properties. So all I need to do here is that, so I just specify the broker's name in the producer config. So just specifying the broker broker string is enough. And once you have that, so these are just an additional messages that I'm using here. So 1-2 messages per second to int, and for each randomly to generate some numbers there, message number. So val string 1-2 words per message dot to int. Some message I'm trying to make a string, that's it. This is nothing related to real-time logic. So in the producer record, once you have a Kafka producer object, so then you are preparing a message. So val message equal to new producer record of this. Specify the topic, okay? And additionally, the topic group, and what is the string that you want to pass a string message to a particular topic, and producer dot send of this message. First, you created a producer object, and what is the record that you can send to producer, that you will send it here. Okay. So if you just want to test this, you can run this, and you can you can consume those messages even from your console consumer, or you can write your custom consumer as well. Okay, and before that, give me a minute break. I will be back telling you. Maybe. Okay. Let's say I have this run as a Scala application. Same, I will show you this pom.xml file also if you want to build that. This is under Kafka POC and Kafka underscore Spark. I'm sure which one runs fine. So I'm writing them onto a sample topic, or instead of that, if I specify sample 01 and maybe words per message, these are the two some random numbers to use to. I'm there. And if I start producing them, here I'm not doing any stuff, but let me consume them. Console consumer. Console consumer. So I should not give the zookeeper broker list. Zookeeper localhost 2181. Topic is sample 01. So it's not yet getting launched. Okay. So it's getting launched. See, some random numbers I'm generating. So whatever the producer is producing, I mean, just this is simple API I'm trying to show you. So once you understand the template, like, so what is what? So all you have in this is, so instead of your Kafka console producer, we write our own our own custom producer. So all this logic is, you have to create first Kafka producer object by passing the broker address, the brokers, the topic. Okay, which is my, I have shown you that, right? So what is my broker details there? So I'm getting connected to by default localhost 9092. The same that the broker list that I was giving on the terminal for my producer, same stuff, same parameters I'm giving there, that's it. So these are the two parameters that I was giving to my console producer. So the same stuff I have to provide to my program also. I should specify the broker name and the topic. And the broker name will be used to create the broker the producer object. And you should prepare one another object for sending the record as well. The producer record. The producer record, you should specify to which topic you want to send that. You already, this just will have a topic name and what is the message and the topic group, or if in case if you have any groups kind of mechanism. Okay, even I didn't use much of them, those grouping of those topics or something. So if you specify that message and just call this, only three methods. Okay, so it's a simple one. Now instead of getting them onto your console, if you want to write your own console or it would be console consumer example. It's bit more than that, or I can show you one of the real time consumer than the sample ones. Okay, so the scenario is like where we were getting some there are some set of tables for a different systems. We have a different systems in our enterprise organization. We are getting those, we have different tables in each of those systems. Okay, assume like we have around 100 plus tables in one of the application related the source data tables, and other systems are having their own tables. Okay, and we used to get new records into each of these Hive tables every day as a separate partition. Okay, so as a separate partition, we are getting those records every day. The new records getting coming. Let's assume if you take this example itself. So this test method override detail.dat. So from this file, we have our data loaded into so this table in real time. And how many records are written? So today, how many records are received? 990 records are received. So along with that, the one, the ingestion one, or the sender who sends the records or pushes the records onto HDFS, along with this DAT files, he sends us this statistics. Okay, and statistics, and these statistics, it might be a continuous one where we keep on receiving the these files on the same day multiple times. Also the same files can be received multiple times again and again the same day. So for the same table, so at any point of time they can arrive in a day. Then once we receive the statistics, so we wanted to maintain this instead of in a file, we wanted to maintain in a HBase tables. Okay, and we wanted to keep monitoring these files continuously from a directory. So actual data will be copied onto this dot DAT files that will get copied, and they will get loaded into your Hive tables. This is just say to maintain the statistics about, so on each table on each day, what are the records that are received? Just only three columns. Let's make that use case simple. Keep that use case simple. So this is just to collect the statistics and store it in your HBase table. Okay, so why HBase, all those things, let's not worry about that right now. So we just wanted to maintain some other things also, considering stuff. So with this use case, you will be able to first, in this use case itself, you will see how the integration with your HBase, how to integrate your Spark with your HBase. So that you will get covered, and your custom producer and custom consumer and integration with your Spark streaming. Because I don't want all these records, I don't want to store this file as it is onto HDFS if these files are coming onto my either local directories on my edge node. If these files are coming onto local directories, I don't want to push them as it is. I just only need what's the table name. So table name is like test underscore header or test underscore base and test underscore customer. test underscore history. Okay. That's the table name underscore STG underscore staging or underscore whatever the environment based. So we append that suffix to build the table name, and we just write the records, number of records, and we just take the date header and use that into another column. So date column, so that date value. Okay. So in this case, it's just, I mean, I'm showing it on just one file. It's like a, in real time, like we wrote this program to be generic enough to traverse through the sub levels of any level, any nested levels of directories, and pick those files from any system. Each system will have a separate subdirectory again in that, and for each subsystem, the table names, the prefixing will start differently. So we are using some kind of here I'm just giving you a direct path, but we made it as a when we were running, so we made it as like to traverse through the nested levels of directories and pick all the files. Okay, so even in this, so what I'm trying to make you understand is that, so from producer or from consumer point of view, even if I show you the simple, the vote count one, the same API that you are going to use, based on the use case, your actual logic will differ. That's it. Okay. So let me show you those things. So in this log producer, so I mean, this is not like a productionized code, right? So I just specified this when I was testing in my Quickstart VM. So localhost is the bro 9092. So I can even take this from the command line, or I declare it here, and topic name I just specified as test. Okay, so from test, I specified the broker address and left all the remaining properties from that as it is. Now using this properties hash map, I created the Kafka producer object, and then, so now I need to produce that producer record. Producer record, what I should send? The message, a record by record, should be sent to that. For each record, we should send that as a separate message, right? A message means a separate record to that topic name. So to prepare that record, what are the values that I need? Either I can pass these records as it is here and process them a bit, process or parse that file and select only the columns or filter only the data that you need on the consumer side, or you can even do it on your producer side as well. So as you can see, that producer's speed will be a bit faster. So we did this like on producer side. So producer side in your Scala, so as I was showing you source.from file to read from any file, dot get lines, maybe you guys remember it or not till now, might have forgot, this is the syntax to read a line by line. So this gives you a loop of line and just applying some pattern matching with regular expression to get the file name, the first one, like any non-string, slash slash w means a word, right, in regular expression pattern, and followed by the space if it is having, so that will be collected into the first box, it, and then input file name after that, so then, and anything that comes with backslash this thing, and this, if you have anything in the parenthesis, that value will be captured into this date pattern. So we have written our regular expression from this line, input file name. So all these things, other than this, if you receive some numbers, this is the what we get into this regular expression. So we get the date pattern, date into that. So date, the pattern I have written, and matcher of line. So if the line matches that date pattern, and date is find, date is found, I'm taking that date into this thing. Out of that, I'm selecting only this dot one, and actual date will be collected here. This one another example for using your regular expression. Okay, and then I'm again writing another regular expression to fetch the file name from each record. The file name will always be something like this, file name equal to, so based on the pattern, and dot that, so that I am using that, the file pattern. So file name I got. After this we did some more modifications to derive the table name, but at least to fetch the basic, the file name excluding the dot that. So I just got file name dot length minus 4 means excluding the dot that. So I got this. Then, so the return pattern to get the how many records written, 495 or 32 or 990, how many. So I extracted that one also from the each line, because it's not a semi-structured file also, right? Only these lines you can separate them by pipe, but these lines you can't separate them by pipes, right? So that's why I make use of the regex. Okay, and now I extracted the three columns, the date, the file name, and the return, and I made it as a one string now, where values file name, pipe, number of records, and pipe date. I'm producing them to this topic. So they are now sent to the broker. So once they are sent to the broker, so I'm consuming them, log consumer, using the log consumer. Simple example is that. So if you write your own plain consumer for Scala, Kafka, it might be a bit bit complex, but always we use that in combination with Spark Streaming. So you can refer to this. So what I am trying to do is consumer, I'm not crossing anything specific inside your Kafka, I'm directly creating the Spark Streaming context with the Spark conf and set master, all this stuff, the conf. Either after creating the Spark context also, Spark conf, all that stuff also, you can do that. But here I'm directly creating by passing this. Either of this is fine. I have the Spark Streaming context. If I know the Spark Streaming context, as we have seen in the advanced sources, to create these streams from your Kafka, all we need is Kafka utils. So Kafka utils dot Kafka utils dot create data direct stream. Okay, so these are some of the generals that we have specified here. SSC, and what are the Kafka parameters, and what is the topic that you should listen on, and the underscore 2 means the value part you have to keep listening on instead of the key part. So here, what are the Kafka parameters? The metadata broker list, you're specifying the broker onto which you should get connected. Okay, so here, unlike your console, this thing where we use the console consumer, where we used to give the zookeeper, right? So that's why I especially written it this way, like, so hostname colon port number for Kafka brokers, but not for your zookeeper. Your custom console, when writing, we have to give with the broker list. Okay, so once you give the broker list this way and specify the topic name, so either use this topics here or set up test the same here. So once you have this, you will be able to receive your lines into this is your lines tree stream and process them each line separately, c dot collect dot to list. You will each RDD, C is nothing but an RDD now. Lines is a D stream, and inside the D stream for every RDD, so C dot collect means you get a list of records, and I'm converting that into to list and processing them. So again, find that file name. So file name, if it is the file name pattern, date pattern, date matches there. If it is having the date record as it is, I'm producing that to campaign printing date consumer side. I really need not to do all this stuff. I suppressed the processing of these lines. Okay. So now println and of F itself will print the pipe separated, the three columns, and I just need to do is, so write them into values, split that by here, this thing, data array is nothing but values dot, so where values, file name is not empty, number of records, unnecessarily doing all this stuff here once again. Okay. Okay. So once I have this values array, if you remember your HBase Java API, this is your Scala API for the same thing. First we create the HBase configuration. So HBase configuration dot create and specify the table name on the there and created the HTable instance. So once you have HBase conf object, so creating the HTable instance conf comma table name and put them into and using here for the dummy records, I'm using the timestamp as the key and put key dot bytes. Okay. And specify add to each one of those records what is the column family and what is the column name. Column family I just have CF, and column names I have file name and records written and date. Okay, and the last one is the actual value from that data array. So if I start producing this records, as long as my broker is running, so it's produced these values. And the better way to start is first start your consumer. Remove old batch metadata, starting job streaming job, block manager, so this is a log consumer one. So let me stop the producer once again. Kafka vote count producer, I'm stopping there, and you start producing this. Log producer produce them, and in log consumer you may see these, the pipe separated these things, consumed there. And if you go and check the HBase shell, you can check them as well. Whatever the table name that we have given, the same Java API as to your HBase. So HBase configuration creation and HTable instance. And if you want to insert, put object. If you want to get object. And if you want to scan object. And the same API, like passing the column family name, column name, and the value. The table name is specified is Kafka_Spark. Maybe if you scan that, can't get master address from zookeeper. I think the master is not running. Sudo service HBase-master. Restart. Region server restart, and we have to restart the zookeeper column as well, zookeeper server as well. So if I stop the zookeeper, our services may get failed. These might throw an exception. I shared this sample Spark streaming project also for you in the code. So this is apart from the POCs. So this is the one thing that we did for our one of the use cases in the UAT environment. Okay. Spark streaming project. This contains all the dependencies. And Spark stream Twitter test. I will put this Kafka code as well. Then I will, since that is like not having much Spark streaming, Kafka Spark streaming log processor, I will put that. Seems like there is Scala is missing. I think there is nothing in this. Okay, maybe I will put this project also for you. It's Scala one also for your samples practicing. Thank you. So that's so one way to write your so you have tested with your testing console producer and consumer, and you know how to write the API to your own API to producer, and how to integrate that with your Spark streaming. So one working use case that we have seen. Okay, it's the same process for anything else as well. Scan here. What's the table? Kafka and Spark. You can see this is how we were inserting records. Later we changed this on to instead of yeah. Later we changed this to have this by table name and date as a key. So initially we used the timestamp one. You can see that code there. Okay, so don't go by the logic that we have here. So and try to understand the custom API, how we can technically achieve it. Okay, I'm killing the consumer also now.
I think to understand we need to go through this video 2-3 times.
It's a simple API only. Only thing is, you just in producer you have to create two objects. One is a Kafka producer object by passing the broker address, and when sending the message to the producer from producer, you need a producer record object with specifying which topic and what is the message, and that message or the producer record you have to send through your producer object method, send method. This is the send method. That's the only method that we use. Okay, so consumer API, the fetch response, it might be of bit maybe bit complex, but you may refer that if you want. But generally the endpoint always target will be the Spark streaming. Most of the times this is the best combination to use the Spark streaming integration, working piece of code. You can see them. That's in real time, you just instead of local host, it will change them to actual the host names and port numbers. That's it. And the topics that you create, and that's it. A bit of more generic code.